Hey guys, welcome to Prasus Medlage. I hope you all are doing good and have watched my previous videos. If not, what are you waiting for? Go for those after the end of this video. Now, without wasting any time further, let's get into today's topic. So today's topic is CO poisoning, that is carbon monoxide poisoning. Okay, so let's start. So carbon monoxide is a colorless and odorless gas which is produced by faulty appliances burning organic fuels. Okay, this carbon monoxide reduces the tissue oxygen delivery and inhibits cellular respiration. As a result, this finally leads to the death of the patient. Okay, now coming to the clinical features, the early features include headache, nausea, irritability, weakness, tachypnea, that is increased respiratory rate. Subsequently, drowsiness, nystagmus may also develop. And finally, the patient also progressed to coma, convulsions, respiratory depression, then cardiovascular collapse, and finally death. Cerebral edema and renal failure can also occur in these patients. Those who recover from acute toxicity, that is acute carbon monoxide toxicity, commonly will have long-term neuropsychiatric effects like personality change. Okay, then poisoning of a pregnant female may lead to intrauterine death of the fetus. Okay, this is also an important point. Now coming to the investigations, so investigation is measurement of carboxyhemoglobin to confirm the exposure, then ECG should be performed in all patients with acute CO poisoning. Arterial blood gas analysis should be checked in those with serious poisoning with carbon monoxide. Coming to the management, patients should be removed from the exposure as soon as possible. Okay, very important. Then a high concentration of oxygen should be administered to the patient via a tightly fitting face mask. This is the mainstay of treatment. Then convulsions should be controlled with diazepam. Excessive intravenous fluid administration should be avoided in these patients because it can lead to pulmonary edema. So excessive intravenous fluid administration should be avoided in these patients. So that was about carbon monoxide poisoning. Now let's revise it. It's a very short topic. Let's revise it once again. So first is carbon monoxide poisoning. What is carbon monoxide? It is a colorless, odorless gas which is produced by faulty appliances burning organic fuels. It reduces the oxygen delivery to the tissues and inhibits cellular respiration. Clinical features: initially, the patient can have headache, nausea, irritability, weakness, tachypnea. Following that, the patient will also develop drowsiness, nystagmus, then coma, convulsions, respiratory depression, cardiovascular collapse, and death. Cerebral edema and renal failure can also develop in these patients, and the patients who survive and recover from the acute toxicity can have long-term neuropsychiatric effects like personality change, etc. And memory loss can also be there. Then poisoning of the pregnant female may lead to intrauterine death of the fetus. Investigations: measurement of carboxyhemoglobin has to be done. ECG has to be done in all acute CO poisoning cases. Arterial blood gas analysis should be done in the patients with serious poisoning with carbon monoxide. And the management should be: remove the patient from the exposure as soon as possible, then give high concentration of oxygen to the patient via a tightly fitting face mask. And convulsions should be controlled with the help of diazepam. And in these patients, intravenous fluid administration should not be excessive so as to prevent pulmonary edema and cerebral edema. That's it guys. So I hope the video was useful. So if you like my content, please do like, share, subscribe, comment, and also press the bell icon to get updated whenever I post a new video. And you can click on either of the two videos to look for organophosphate poisoning and methanol poisoning. That's it guys. Thank you.